Hello everyone, my name is Louisa Bochniak, content creator at Lightmap, and I am back with another interview with a 3D artist. It's my pleasure to introduce to you guys Iman Kimiyai, who is not only a 3D artist, but also one of the co-founders at Kimagination, a visualization studio in Poland. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the video. Iman Kimiyai is a 3D generalist originally from Iran. He has a background in a number of fields, including cinema and film, architecture, and 3D. His mission is to always combine the skills from all these fields and utilize this energy into his 3D projects. Since opening his own micro studio in Poland, he's completed various projects around the world for product advertisement and architectural visualizations. Synergy Skin, Eagle Vision, and For Me are just some of Iman's many clients at Kimagination. Hi Iman, how are you?
Hi, fine, thank you very much.
Awesome. It's really nice to finally meet online. We've been chatting back and forth via email, so it's really nice to finally see you.
Likewise. It's a privilege for me to be on your...
It's our pleasure. Thank you so much for wanting to do this with us. I can't wait to get to know you better. So shall we get started?
Yes, of course.
Let's go. I'm interested to find out about your background. Did you go to university? If so, did you? What kind of courses did you study?
Yes, actually, I studied cinema and I majored in film directing when I was back in Iran in the years 2003. Mm-hmm. And after that, I've decided to move to Poland and study architecture, continue my studies with inside the architecture field, and right now I'm doing mainly 3D visualizations for products.
Awesome. So what happened after you've graduated? Did you stay in Poland?
I had a very good opportunity. I think it was third year of a study to meet Rafał Barnasz, Unique Vision Studio. After that, I met another fantastic Polish designer, Max Kobiela, and then I started to work with these guys, and little by little, I find my own path.
Yeah. Is it after 2 years of graduating, did you open or start your own business to do with 3D?
Yes.
How did you find the courage and the confidence? How did you prepare for that moment?
It was a little bit hard because, you know, there are always this kind of bad thought that you cannot do it, or, you know, there is something is going to happen. But, you should jump inside, and you should try to do the action, yeah, and you will see the result. So it was hard for me, and actually because of the pandemic situation right now, I had to outsource some of the things that I could do earlier. So right now I'm a little back, but I'm trying to move forward as soon as possible.
Tell me a bit more about your business. If I'm not wrong, you Kimagination, I should say, is the studio name. Where did that name come from?
You know, it was like I wanted to make a name based on my surname. Because it's Kimiyai, so it starts with Kim, but it's also like imagination. So I tried to find something.
I think you did a really nice play on words there. I see the meaning now, and it actually makes up a nice word to do with being imaginative. So I think it's got a really nice meaning to it. I like it.
Yes, because I believe that when it comes to 3D visualizations, the only limitation is your what you can imagine. So if you can imagine something, you will be able to create it in 3D.
So who's on your team? And do you specialize in a certain aspect of 3D?
Actually, I'm a 3D generalist myself, so I'm specializing mostly on modeling and like rendering and lighting and every other stuff these fields. But from time to time, when I need other stuffs like working with particle systems or hair or something like this, I will outsource those works to another talented 3D artist that I have on my team. At the moment I'm working with also a very brilliant architect in Canada. His name is Maziar Mohit, and we participated in several competitions which we had the chance to recently receive a Silver A Design Award.
For
the new watch which we created together.
So participating in competitions, is that just for fun, or is it to raise, you know, brand awareness?
So it's actually for us, it's not only brand awareness, it's like we want to find a chance to give, find like investors for our architectural ideas and concepts.
That sounds great. So I'd like to know more about the tools and your 3D workflow. Can you tell me what tools, you know, your 3D modeling software, and any renderers, and do you use any plugins?
Yes, actually I tried many softwares, but at the end I believe that Blender is a very, very reliable software right now. I'm very glad using that, and since I think 3-4 years I mainly use Blender as the main software in my studio, and when it comes to render engines, cycles, and recently I'm trying to understand a little bit more Unreal Engine and Octane Render, so to use them as like somehow incorporate them inside the workflow. For my thing, right now Cycles is extremely powerful, and I really like enjoy working with that.
Do you think Cycles could be one of the reasons why you like Blender so much? You've mentioned using several different 3D apps before, so I'm assuming Blender wasn't the first app that you've used. Because
yes,
normally... cutting each other off. Problems of speaking online. So normally people... that's what I've heard anyway. A lot of 3D artists have... prefer the 3D software that they've learned to use first, and then they kind of stick with it. Whereas in your case, it's quite different because you've tried many different software before trying Blender and ended up sticking with Blender. So I'm just quite intrigued by that and interested to know a little bit more behind your reasonings as to why you like Blender so much.
Actually, Cycles was not the main reason, because Cycles has quite a lot of limitations, especially when it comes, for example, to lighting glass and house and everything. So there was like one render engine, Corona Render, and I really like that. And I think it for my field of work, that is the perfect thing. But unfortunately, they don't want to like... incorporate it inside Blender, or don't want to have a relation with. I'm not sure what is the reason, but unfortunately, it's not available for Blender users. But when it comes to Cycles, it was not my main reason. The main reason that I really like Blender is First of all, the user interface is extremely intuitive and it's shortcut based. Like when I'm creating modeling, I never experienced something like this. Like it's like playing on the over the piano. You know, it's when you are getting used to the shortcuts and everything, so you don't think like it's like your hands automatically just do what your brain needs to do. So I really, really like this aspect of Blender, and controlling everything is much easier. And you can have a great preview in real time, even with Eevee. And that is one reason. The other reason was the community of Blender. So like people, if you have a question, immediately you will have like hundreds of answers from people who are humble. Yeah. They want to help. And that's I believe also it's very important. One other thing about Blender is that it is so lightweight that it's like you can easily install it. You can open it very quickly, and there is a great autosave system. You know, there are many things in Blender that I really, really quite enjoy. But professionally, I really like the way that it's so quick when you are mastering the shortcuts. So it's very, very quick.
Yeah, I know what you mean. I've watched a few Blender tutorials before and I couldn't really keep up, just because the person using Blender just kept using shortcuts, and I was like, whoa, that happened too quick. I had to move back a bit. So I see how quick people can be with this piece of kit.
No, one very important thing is that the shortcuts are not random. So like you are doing it in order. So it's just like, as I mentioned, it's just like music. So like you know what you want to do and you don't need to memorize everything. It's like, you know, so naturally happening when you are working. So that's brilliant.
I saw your portfolio online and I can see your lighting is obviously really sophisticated and elegant. Can you tell me a little bit about your lighting process? How do you light your shots?
So thank you very much. For me, lighting is a process of making a balance between shadows and light. So the process that I have is I'm starting with like one key light that makes a nice gradient, and then I start to shape the object, shape the product based on the reflections. So I'm trying to find like where the reflections or the rim lights are going to like bring the shape out, and I think that's quite simple process. So there is nothing like extreme there, but it gives like a good result at the end.
Yeah. What tools do you use for lighting? Do you create area lights inside Blender, and then because you use HDR Light Studio, right? How do you use HDR Light Studio? Do you use it for creating HDR IMAPs, or do you also mix it up with area lights as well?
Okay. So in general, Blender is very capable of creating almost whatever kind of lighting scenarios that you want. You can like do everything, but there is one problem, and that's it. That's whenever you want to like make a little change, you need to go few steps back and start to do lots of additional steps.
Yeah.
Which it's fine, but when it becomes like 100 times, then it starts to get really against your creativity. And that's when a great plugin or a software will come to help and lets the whole process becomes just a few clicks. I really like HDR Light Studio because in terms of creativity, instead of I put my energy to create new gradients, nodes, and create different shaders and everything. Instead of that, I put my creativity on finding the perfect lighting.
Yeah.
So one other thing is that HDR Light Studio gives you as an artist, because from time to time you create your image and then you start thinking, okay, what if I do something else? And then there is a barrier, something is holding you, because you say, okay, what if I go through all of these steps, and but with something like HDR Light Studio, you don't need to sacrifice something. You just try it and you see if it's good or not.
Yeah.
And that is something that made me sure that it's a good decision to use HDR Light Studio.
Mm-hmm. Is it just area lights you said that you work with?
I'm doing the thing that I'm separating reflections and lights. Mm-hmm. So I make a key light and light the whole scene without reflection. So I turn off all the reflections and then I start to paint the reflections only.
I see what you mean. Yeah.
Yeah. So it can be different stuffs like a spotlight, area lights, and all mm-hmm. different stuffs.
Did you feel like you've got a problem with your previous lighting workflow? Is that, did you go out searching for a different plugin or a solution to your problem, or did you find about HDR Light Studio accidentally?
I find about HDR Light Studio a little bit accidentally, because I remember I watched a promo of a car lighting, like something very beautiful car animation, and then I saw that it's made by HDR Light Studio. I went and found out about that. Then I started to watch all these great interviews, tutorials, and mm-hmm. other stuffs. That was. I remember I watched an interview with Phil Seals.
Oh yeah.
It was like some kind of workshop when he was trying to light these products, and that was like I wanted to experience the
I know which video you're talking about. Link will be in the description for anyone interested. What would be your favorite HDR Light Studio feature? I know you like playing about with different lights that we that HDR Light Studio ships with. Is there any feature that you really appreciate?
Exactly. More than feature, the whole structure of HDR Light Studio is very, very interesting for me, because as I've mentioned, you don't need to go back and forth and try, and so you have everything. But when it comes to features, there are lots of features that I really, really enjoy, but I can mention a few. Like the first one is this light painting. So it's very important for me to exactly place my reflections on the product that I'm working with. So Light Studio has this amazing feature that you can just click and drag on the point that you like your reflection to appear, and you can see that. Except on that, there is this fascinating curves that you can work with, and you can control everything, because I believe curves was the biggest invention of in 3D computer image generation, like these curves, because they give you absolute control over what you want to do. And in HDR Studio you will have these curves. Curves for transparency, you will have them for value, for color, so you can use that in your advantage. And the other thing that I really enjoy is that you can immediately solo one light and you know, and just concentrate on that one, because the more I get mature in what I'm doing, the more I urge for control over what I'm doing. Earlier in my career, I was like lots of things based on happenings, but right now control is the absolute things that I think that I really want to have, and that is where HDR Light Studio gives me like this soloing each light, and I can like work with that.
Yeah, I know exactly what you mean. Okay, so picture this: you've got, say, like a foundation product to light. You open up HDR Light Studio. What is your lighting process? Is it the same every time? Does it depend on what you are lighting?
Absolutely not. It cannot be the same every time, because it will become just like fast food, you know?
Yeah.
You need to think about the character of that, the object that you have. You need to think about, what is your plan? What your client wants? Because from time to time, there are different types of clients that I have, each of them has their own like inspiration. They are sharing like pictures that they like, it's completely different. So you need to also incorporate that in with lighting, that is also very important. So it cannot be the same thing all the time.
Yeah.
It doesn't make any sense.
Yeah, there's no like an easy hack to just, if you think like this, you have perfect nice lighting. No, it doesn't work like this. So you've mentioned your clients, and before you said you don't really have any problems obtaining new clients or getting more work. Can you tell me more about this? How did you end up in a position like this? How do you get your clients?
It depends on the types of clients that I have. Like, for example, I have clients that they are working with me for a long time. For example, Synergy, they are working with me for about, I think, 6 years.
Mm-hmm.
There is other companies that right now we have like great, foundational.
Yeah.
Collaboration. So they are just contacting me and say, oh, we have new products, please do this. And then they have kind of clients that I'm mainly working also in Fiverr, and I have they're like, I'm like a top seller, and I find lots of good clients also there.
Yeah.
There are also from social medias. I'm not very particularly good at that part, but it was here and there some clients from. I need to work more on that aspect.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Must be really hard to, because essentially you are the owner of your business. So not only you have the creative aspect of your job, actually doing the visuals, the work your clients ask you to do, but also you've got to worry about the business side, and that includes marketing. So it is a lot of work to do by one person. How do you manage to look after all of those aspects?
I'm the co-founder of the company together with Magda, and Magda very helpful in those kind of situations, like finances, because I absolutely do not don't want to get involved in those things, because it's not my
I wasn't aware that you are the co-founder. I would have invited Magda as well on the call. Maybe next time we can chat about 3D some other time as well. So next time would be nice to meet Magdalena as well. Are you allowed to talk about your current projects?
There was something that I mentioned about this Canadian competition. Right now, I have few clients. I have clients globally from all around the world in different kind of fields. Right now, I'm working on the silent pods that I'm creating 3D visualizations of for a company called Silent Pod, and they are creating this and these pods for open workspaces. I have quite right now a lot of small projects, not huge. So, and that is also the thing that I really like about working with product renderings, because the scale of the work is somehow in a way that you can simultaneously, you can work on more projects, let's say more than like if you work on an architecture or interior design, then you need to dedicate a lot of time to to do that, but with products you can have more freedom of working simultaneously.
Yeah. So how about your favorite 3D process? You've mentioned before you like modeling. Is that your favorite part of 3D?
Actually, I really enjoy. So, like, I really love when I'm sitting over, the computer.
Yeah.
In front of the computer, it's like I'm very happy. I have a smile on my face.
Yeah.
I enjoy every part of working, especially modeling. Like when I'm trying to figure out, it's like people who like creating puzzles, and I really like to do the modeling, like finding out the quads that you need in a model I really like it.
It can be quite relaxing, can't it?
And exactly. And when you see, as your model starts to get, comes to life, and you are looking at it, it's really a feeling that I cannot explain it very well. Like words cannot explain it, because it's really, really fun and really nice when you are seeing your model is in front of your eye.
Yeah, it's very satisfying, I can imagine. What are your goals for the future? And that can be from a 3D artist point of view and also from the business aspect.
As 3D artist, I'm constantly trying to learn new stuff. As I mentioned, I'm trying so hard right now with Unreal Engine and some other softwares. What I really want business wise is to target, instead of having a lot of small projects from various clients, I really want to concentrate on big names and start to have a collaboration with them. That is the target that I have, and I hope that it happens, like the top fashion industry brands or something like this.
That would be really amazing. Yeah. I wish you all the best. I hope all of your dreams come true. And also wish you all the best for your business. It's been a real pleasure talking to you, and thank you so much for agreeing to do this, and hopefully I'll chat with you and Magdalena in the future at some point.
Of course.
Yeah, thank you guys for watching.